His name, which came out in the course of talk, was James Dalroy. He was the son of a bankrupt Irish landlord, and attached to a pink paper which he heartily despised, called Smart Society, in the capacity of reporter and of something painfully like a spy. Smart Society, I regret to say, felt none of that interest in Boulnois on Darwin which was such a credit to the head and hearts of the Western Sun. Dalroy had come down, it seemed, to snuff up the scent of a scandal which might very well end in the divorce court, but which was at present hovering between Grey Cottage and Pendragon Park. Sir Claude Champion was known to the readers of the Western Sun as well as Mr. Boulnois. So were the Pope and the Derby winner. But the idea of their intimate acquaintanceship would have struck Kidd as equally incongruous. He had heard of, and written about, nay, falsely pretended to know Sir Claude Champion as one of the brightest and wealthiest of England's upper ten, as the great sportsman who raced yachts around the world, as the great traveller who wrote books about the Himalayas, as the politician who swept constituencies with a startling sort of Tory democracy, and as the great dabbler in art, music, literature, and above all, acting. Sir Claude was really magnificent in other than American eyes. There was something of the Renaissance prince about his omnivorous culture and restless publicity. He was not only a great amateur, but an ardent one. There was in him none of that antiquarian frivolity that we convey by the word dilettante.